Hello everyone, it's Lindsay, and today I am bringing you some new printables from Ally Scraps, and I'm going to be Bible journaling in my Bible with these, but I wanted to kind of show you what she's got going on over there. So she released this set titled Unbirthday, and it has all kinds of fun goodies, and I also printed out some other things to kind of go along with it. So in the digital set Unbirthday, you get so much stuff. So you get 3 pages of words, and I scaled mine down to fit all three on one sheet of sticker paper. But if you wanted bigger titles, then you could just print them out one on each sheet. You could print these out on cardstock. You could use these for card making. I'm going to be using them in my Bible journaling today, but there are so many fun words all about being reborn, rebirth, your birthday, all those kind of fun things. So you got to celebrate, blow out a candle. It's your day, celebrating you. And the nice thing about printables is you can print them again and again once you have purchased that file from her. So you get a set of words. This is something different. I'll show you that in a second. There are 15 different paper patterns. I only printed out a few of them, and I printed mine out on 8.5 by 11 sheets of paper. And this is some really nice quality paper. I'll link it down below for you guys. And I just printed it with a bleed, so it's all the way to the edge, and I only printed out a few, but there are 15 different papers that you get in that Unbirthday bundle. So you've got the polka dot, you've got crosses, you've got stripes. This one's super cute with the little stars, all kinds of fun geometric patterns. Like I said, there are several other papers included in the kit. You could scale them down and do like 4 papers on a sheet and have them really small. Maybe print out several of them on clear sticker paper and use them to make washi tape out of or punch tabs out of. I'm going to use them to back up some things, I think, or punch some things out of. You could use alphabet dies and die cut alphabets out of these papers. I thought about doing that. So there are a lot of different things that you could do with these papers. You could print them on transparency sheets, on clear sticker paper, whatever you want. So there are those. And then you also get a couple sheets of banners, and these come in black, blue, and pink. I only printed out the black ones, but you have all these different banners, and if you wanted to, you could pull them into a program and resize them. So I will link a playlist down below where I show how I alter printables so you can kind of resize them and pull out certain elements and things like that. So I printed these on cardstock, that way I could cut them out and use them for journaling or a title or something, and some of them have little cupcakes and cakes and things that you could color in. So there's all these fun banners, and so all of these plain ones you could use for a variety of different entries. You could print these out on clear label paper if you wanted to. You could ink these up with distress inks, or all kinds of things to kind of play with these and change them up. So that is everything that comes in the Unbirthday set, and that I'll be using today. And then I also went ahead and printed out. These are some of her art starts. These are meant to coordinate with the Revival Camp kit from Illustrated Faith, but some of the colors and the confetti and things kind of went with the Unbirthday set, so I thought I would use these. The nice thing about these is they're kind of all in one, so you don't have to mess with paint in your Bible, you don't have to mess with glitter, anything like that. You can print these out on clear label paper, cut them out, and you are ready to go. She even has some faux stitching that you can use. And so if you're really worried about bulk in your Bible or something like that, you can use these art starts and get all that fun color and texture without it being actual texture. So I'm going to be using some of these today. She's also got alphabet stickers and prayer cards and all kinds of fun things over there. So definitely check out her shop. I have an affiliate link down below for you guys. And I'll go ahead and put you on fast forward and we will jump in. I am documenting in 2 Corinthians 5:17. And that says, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. And so I'll be documenting that verse using this kit. So I'll go ahead and put you on fast forward and we'll get started.
Okay, so I went ahead and pulled out the different elements that I'm going to use on this page. I did go ahead and use a circle die to punch out some circles from those papers, which we'll use here in a minute. But I'm going to start with some of these art starts. So I have mine printed on clear label paper. And clear label paper is kind of hard to write over. So I want to make sure anything that's going to be underneath that paper is done first. So I'm going to highlight the verse and then stick down this label paper. Now most of this ends up getting covered up. I should have cut it apart and kind of sprinkled it around the page, but that's okay. I didn't foresee that at this point, but I also have this big piece, and here's a trick for adhering down these big stickers. So I kind of peel it back and snip off a piece of the backing, and then I don't fully expose the stickiness, just a little bit of the stickiness, and then I can press that down onto my page, and I have a little bit more control than if I was to be dealing with all of the sticky exposed. I can kind of flip it back, take the rest of the backing off, and smooth that down over the page. So when I take all the backing off and then try to stick it down, this kind of static clings to everything and grabs the page too soon and is kind of a monster to deal with. So by just doing a little bit at a time, it's a bit easier to get those bigger stickers down on the page. So I saved all my trimmings, and I'll go ahead and add some of that to the top of the page here just to bring some color up there where the tab's gonna go. And now we can work on these die cut pieces. So I'll have a circle die and a die cutting machine linked down below for you guys if you're interested. And I'm inking these up just on the edges with some Distress Oxide inks. And this is just gonna help these papers have some more definition and kind of pop out from the background. And these are gonna be balloons. So I'm just adding a touch of color. This is Mermaid Lagoon Distress Oxide ink. I also pulled out Squeezed Lemonade and Worn Lipstick, and those are the three colors I'll be using throughout this entry. And so just taking a mini ink blending tool and adding a little bit of color to the edges just kind of brings in some more color around the page, and just kind of helps them stand out from each other since those patterns are really busy. So here I went ahead and cut out some of the banners, and these were printed on cardstock. And same thing, I'm gonna ink these up with some of that Mermaid Lagoon Distress Oxide ink just to kind of jazz them up so they're not just white. This makes them look a little more finished. And for this piece, it was kind of easier to hold it up and ink it up this way. Distress Oxide inks are really forgiving. They are a pigment and dye ink blend, and so you have some time to kind of move the color and work with it before it completely sinks into the paper, and it just has this really smooth, pretty finish. Now this is something fun. This is Tim Holtz Fringe. I've had this on my desk for a couple months waiting for the perfect moment to play with it. So in the package it looks a little boring. This is Fringe Trim. But hold tight, I'll show you how awesome this is. So this is kind of a crepe paper kind, or like a tissue paper fringe, and it's meant to work with a variety of products. So you could spray inks on this, you could use re-inkers, like ink pad re-inkers to ink it up. You could mush your ink pads on your nonstick craft mat, spray it with water, and then drag this through it. I was trying not to get my fingers too inky, and so I decided just to kind of sponge the color on with these mini ink blending tools, but it probably would have given an even better effect if I had used something wet, whether the inks were wet on the mat or spray inks or something like that. I need to get some gloves in my craft room, that way I can kind of really get crazy with inks and not worry about staining my hands. But I'm just going in, and I chose these three colors because they are kind of like red, blue, yellow, except it's pink, blue, yellow. But by mixing these colors, you can get a rainbow. So you can see where I mix the yellow and the pink, I get an orange. Where the blue and the yellow mix, I get a green. And where the pink and the blue mix, I get a purple. So I'm getting a full rainbow just with these three inks and how I overlap them. And you don't have to be too perfect when inking up this fringe because we are going to crumple this all up. And so it doesn't have to be a perfect blend. It's okay if you can kind of see marks from the blending tools. So I'm just going in and inking that up, and then I will go ahead and flip it over and do the same thing on the back side. Now if you used something liquid and wet, it probably would go ahead and be easier to get both sides and the inside parts of this fringe, but since I'm doing it this way, I have to kind of work in stages here. And I'm using quite a bit of ink, that way it kind of seeps into that paper. And I went ahead and hit that with my heat tool. And here's where the magic happens. So you lightly crumple this fringe up and kind of roll it in your hands. And it just reminds me of like a pinata. I don't know, how awesome is this? So it gets all kinds of dimension, and there's so many different ways that you can use this fringe, ink it up with different colors, all kinds of things. So now I have this rainbow fringe trim, and I'm gonna use a piece of it for a tab up here at the top, and then bring a little bit of it down to the bottom of the page, just to add some texture, because I'm really working with lots of stickers and papers and not anything two dimensional at this point. So this just adds some fun to the page. I'm going to adhere the tab portion with my tiny attacher. And what you don't see on camera is I actually stapled two of my pages together and tore the back page trying to separate it, but it's okay. I will deal with it at another time, but just be careful when you're stapling that you don't staple two pages together like I did. For this bottom piece, I'm going to use some liquid adhesive to adhere it down. I was afraid that the dry adhesive roller wouldn't be quite enough to hold this on there since it is really fluffy and dimensional. And of course, once my Bible's closed, this will kind of get mushed down a little bit, but that's okay. It has this really fun texture to it. So here I cut out some of the words from the printables, and I'm going to adhere those down onto these banners. And it just so happened that I had resized them to a good size that fit on these banners. So it's going to be Celebrate Rebirth. I love that this kit really encourages you to do exactly that. Celebrate how we are reborn through Christ, and as Christians, we are a new creation. So I love that we can document that with this printable set. Here's this little bow that was part of the Art Start page, and that is what's gonna tie my balloons together here so we can start adhering these down. If you printed these on cardstock, you could pop them up with some foam tape. I didn't, they're just on that regular copy paper, and so I'm just adhering them directly down to the page. Now, some of the text does get covered up. If that bothers you, you could definitely print all of these in clear sticker paper or transparency sheets, or scale them down smaller, and then you wouldn't cover the text. But my Bible verse is right there highlighted, and I can still read the verse, and that's what is important for this entry. And again, just adhering these down with some adhesive. And I want to put that bow down before I draw my lines, because the lines will be able to be seen through that clear sticker paper. So I want to make sure I get that down first. And then I'm going to use a ruler to draw my little balloon strings. Now, at first I started to try to use my favorite Castel pen, but those don't write over clear label paper. So I remembered I have this Slick Writer pen from scrapbook.com. These are great for writing over sticker paper. However, they do bleed through your Bible page if it's just on regular Bible paper and not the sticker. So what I should have done was use this over the sticker and then use the other pen on the regular page, but I didn't. So I did have some bleed through. Oh well, it happens. It's not the end of the world. But it is nice to have a pen that will write over that label paper, because it is pretty difficult to write over. And then I'll go in and just add some details around the balloons just to help them stand out more. And this is where I got a lot of bleed through, is where I did that there. And that is it for the entry today. So if you have any questions or comments, be sure to leave those down below. Check out the description box for links to all these products from Allie Scraps. Thank you, Allie, for sending these over to me to play with. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to my channel if you're not already subscribed. And until next time, thank you so much. Bye-bye.